our celebrant. Please join me in praying our parish prayer. Let us pray. Soul of Jesus, sanctify me. Body of Jesus, save me. Blood of Jesus, fill me. Water from Jesus' side, wash me. Passion of Jesus, strengthen me. Within your holy wounds, shelter me. To the service of my neighbor, draw me. To become a more authentic Christian, transform me. Holy Spirit, guide me. At the moment of my death, call me, that we as a church parish may praise you with your angels and saints forever and ever. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate again this day the mystery of God's great love for us, first we call to mind our sins.
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done and gain strength to do what they've seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The Holy Spirit says, "Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at the rebellion, in the day of testing in the desert, where your ancestors tested and tried me, and saw my works for 40 years. Because of this, I was provoked with that generation, and I said, they have always been of erring heart, and they do not know my ways. As I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest. Take care, brothers and sisters, that none of you may have an evil and unfaithful heart, so as to forsake the living God. Encourage yourselves daily while it is still today, so that none of you may grow hardened by the deceit of sin. We have become partners of Christ, if only we hold the beginning of the reality firm until the end." The word of the Lord. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us, for he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they hadn't seen my works. Forty years I was wearied of that generation. I said, this people's heart goes astray. They do not know my ways. Therefore I swore in my anger, they shall never enter my rest.
If they hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
peace among the people. Alleluia, alleluia.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
A leper came to him, kneeling down, begged him and said, "If you wish, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand, touched the leper and said to him, "I do will it, be made clean." The leprosy left him immediately, and he was made clean. Then, warning him sternly, he dismissed him at once. Then he said to him, "See that you tell no one anything, but go show yourself to the priests and offer for your cleansing what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The man went away and began to publicize the whole matter. He spread the report abroad, so that it was impossible for Jesus to enter a town openly. He remained outside in deserted places, and people kept coming to him from everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning. My name is Father Gil Dutel, and as of July of this past year, I became a retired priest of the Diocese of Lafayette, and I live in Scott. I was pastor at St. Edmund's, just to the northwest of here. St. Edmund's and Holy Cross parishes touch one another. So now I live in Scott. Your pastor here, Father Mario, was an associate with me when the both of us were in Scott together several years ago. So I know Father Mario well, a great man, great priest. Happy to be with you. It's the first time I celebrate Mass here at Holy Cross. I've never celebrated Mass here before. It's a beautiful church. Thank you for coming this morning. Happy to help Father Mario. And just a short reflection on the gospel passage of Jesus encountering the leper, in which the leper approaches Jesus and says, "If you wish, you can heal me." A little better than 2 years ago, after a series of kind of testing and wondering what was going on, they discovered that I had a brain tumor. And so I underwent surgery for it, and thank goodness it was benign. And the recovery has been really spectacular for me, slow but spectacular in terms of how God has helped. It was at that time, a little better than 2 years ago when that discovery was made, that this particular gospel and this particular incident really hit me between the eyes and helped me to make a great deal of sense of what Jesus prayed in the agony before his death on Good Friday, when Jesus said, "Father, if you wish, you can take this cup from me." And so every night before I go to bed, I always sigh myself and say, "Lord, if you wish, you can heal me in body, mind, and spirit." And that has proven to be a great source of consolation. And I'm grateful, at least at this point in my life, that the Lord has listened. And just last week went for an MRI to make sure that the tumor was not returning, and it's not. I think the Lord teaches us through this leper today, as the Lord himself teaches us with his own prayer life, that indeed the only real way to pray is to put it in God's hands. We talk about putting things in God's hands, but boy, we're quick to take it back, aren't we, many times? Amen?
Amen.
have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May your people, so Glacian, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore them to holiness and obtain what they devoutly entreat, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent, Father, as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Father, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, Jesus stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas Desitel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. ask you, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacraments may also serve with lives pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.